In this closer look, we'll learn how to perform calculations involving wavelength, frequency, and energy. In Unit 3, we looked at atomic structure, including the subatomic particle, the electron. In this video, we'll investigate the nature of light and energy, which will help us to better understand the electron. First, we need to look at electromagnetic radiation, forms of energy that are around us all the time, including radio waves, visible light, and gamma radiation. There are three fundamental properties of electromagnetic radiation that allow us to perform the calculations you'll see in this video. The first property of electromagnetic radiation is that each type has a characteristic wavelength, which is the distance between two corresponding points on a wave. Before we do any calculations with waves, we want to have our measurement of wavelength in meters. If the wavelength measurement is not given in meters, it should be converted to meters before plugging it into the equation. The second property of electromagnetic radiation is frequency, which indicates how many waves pass a given point per second. We want to measure frequency in hertz, which is also sometimes reported as seconds to the negative one power. Hertz and seconds to the negative one power mean the same thing. A wave with a frequency of 1 hertz means one wave will pass a given point per second. 2 hertz means two waves will pass a given point per second, and so on. The third property of electromagnetic radiation is velocity. All forms of electromagnetic radiation travel at the same velocity, the speed of light, or 3.00 times 10 to the 8th meters per second. This establishes an inverse relationship between frequency and wavelength. We can see this inverse relationship with the speed of light equation, where the speed of light, represented by C, is equal to the wavelength times frequency. That's what these variables stand for. Lambda, which stands for wavelength, times nu, which stands for frequency. So you see that if the speed of light is constant, which it is, then if wavelength is going to increase, frequency must decrease, and vice versa. So let's look at a couple of practice problems to calculate wavelength or frequency using the speed of light equation. Problem 1 gives us wavelength and asks us to solve for the frequency of a sodium vapor light. We'll rearrange the speed of light equation for frequency, and we'll do that by dividing both sides of the equation by the wavelength. This will get frequency by itself on one side of the equation. Now that we have our speed of light equation rearranged in terms of frequency, we can plug in the values that we know. We know the speed of light, which again is 3.00 times 10 to the 8th meters per second. And this question gives us the wavelength, which is 5.89 times 10 to the negative 7th meters. We plug those into our expression here and solve for frequency. So when we divide 3.00 times 10 to the 8th meters per second by 5.89 times 10 to the negative 7th meters, we get 5.09 times 10 to the 14th power. Notice that meters in the numerator cancel out meters in the denominator. And after the meters are canceled, our unit is per second. We can write that as s to the negative 1 power, or more commonly, those are referred to as hertz. That's what a hertz is. It's a unit that means per second. Remember, frequency is a measurement of how many waves are passing a given point per second. So the frequency of the light emitted from a sodium vapor light is 5.09 times 10 to the 14th hertz. In our second problem, we want to calculate the wavelength of an FM signal from a radio station. We're given the frequency of the radiation, but it's in megahertz, so we need to convert that to hertz before we plug it into our equation. Since the prefix mega means million, we'll convert megahertz to hertz by multiplying megahertz by 1 million. When we do that, we find that 88.5 megahertz is the same frequency as 8.85 times 10 to the 7th hertz. Since we're solving for wavelength, we'll need to rearrange our equation by dividing both sides of the equation by the frequency. This will get wavelength by itself on one side of the equation. We then plug in our values for the speed and frequency. The speed of the radiation is always 3.00 times 10 to the 8th meters per second. So we'll plug that into the numerator. The frequency, 8.85 times 10 to the 7th hertz, will be plugged into the denominator. We find that the wavelength of the FM signal from our radio station is 3.39 meters, since the units of per second canceled out. 3.39 meters is a pretty long wavelength compared to our other types of electromagnetic radiation. It's this long wavelength with a very small frequency that makes this type of radiation safe. In fact, you're being bombarded with radio waves right now. Next, we're going to look at how we can quantify the amount of energy these various types of radiation carry. As strange as this sounds, light has both a wave and a particle nature. In this picture, you see glowing hot liquid metal, and this type of light is called blackbody radiation. It occurs when opaque, non-reflective materials are at high temperatures and emit radiation. And this emission of light cannot be explained by thinking of light as a wave. Max Planck explained this phenomenon by assuming that energy is quantized and comes in packets called quanta. We explored this phenomenon in our Unit 3 flame test lab. Planck was able to show that the energy of a packet of light, also called a photon, is proportional to the frequency of that light. We can use Planck's equation to calculate the energy of a photon. H in Planck's equation is Planck's constant. Its value is 6.626 times 10 to the negative 34th joules times seconds. So if we know the wavelength or frequency of light, we can calculate the energy in one photon or packet of that light. Ready to practice? Our first practice problem asked us to solve for the energy of a photon of red light whose frequency is 4.0 times 10 to the 14th hertz. We'll use Planck's equation and plug in the 4.0 times 10 to the 14th for the frequency. We'll multiply that by Planck's constant to find the energy of a red photon. So we have here Planck's constant, 6.626 times 10 to the negative 34th joules times seconds, times frequency, 4.0 times 10 to the 14th per second, or hertz, and we find that the energy of a photon of red light will be 2.7 times 10 to the negative 19 joules. Let's go to our second problem. In this one, we're calculating the energy of a photon of green light. This one is a little more complex because we're given wavelength and asked to solve for energy. But we can use the speed of light equation and rearrange that to solve for the frequency. So plugging in 3.00 times 10 to the 8th meters per second into the numerator, and 5.20 times 10 to the negative 7th meters into the denominator, we find that the frequency is 5.77 times 10 to the 14th hertz. Then we plug that frequency into Planck's equation along with the constant that we know, Planck's constant, and we can then find the energy of one photon of green light. Now that we've solved for the frequency, 5.77 times 10 to the 14th hertz, we're going to use Planck's equation and multiply this frequency times Planck's constant. So what we find out is that the energy of this green photon of light has a value of 3.82 times 10 to the negative 19th joules. And you may have noticed that in some questions we've referenced frequency units as per second, and in other questions we referenced it as a hertz. Remember, these two mean the same thing. So once we multiply these two values together, everything will cancel except for the joules. You now have a better understanding of how to calculate waves and frequency using the speed of light equation, and also how to solve for the energy of light using Planck's constant and the equation E equals H times nu. We've done practice problems calculating frequency, wavelength, and energy using our constant of the speed of light. Now, why don't you try one on your own? I'll give you the problem and then press pause and see if you can solve it. When you have your answer, press play to see if you got it right. Ready? Here's the problem. Calculate the wavelength and energy of light that has a frequency of 5.0 times 10 to the 14th Hertz. Now press pause and solve the problem. For this question, we had to solve both the wavelength and the energy of light. If you answer that wavelength was 6.0 times 10 to the negative 7th meters, you got it right. To recap, we use the speed of light equation, which is the speed of light equals wavelength times frequency, and the speed of light is a constant, 3.0 times 10 to the 8th meters per second. Frequency was given in the problem, 5.0 times 10 to the 14th Hertz. So we put that here and rearrange the equation for wavelength by dividing both sides of the equation by the frequency. And that's how we find that the wavelength is 6.0 times 10 to the negative 7th meters. Now for the energy calculation. The correct answer is 3.3 times 10 to the negative 19th joules. If you got that, good work. Remember that energy is directly proportional to frequency. So for this calculation, we take Planck's constant and we multiply it times frequency, which was given to us in the problem. Remember that the unit, waves per second, is the same as a hertz. And that's how we get our final answer, 3.3 times 10 to the negative 19th joules of energy. That's a closer look at calculating wavelength, frequency, and energy. For more chemistry matters, go to our homepage, where you can find the entire series.